The epidermal growth factor receptor, EGFR, located at the cell surface. It's a growth factor receptor, which means it stimulates cell growth. The binding of a ligand activates the receptor, induces phosphorylation of intracellular substrates, results in cell growth and DNA synthesis. In a large number of cancer cells, EGFR is mutated or overexpressed. EGFR inhibitors are drugs that inhibit cancer proliferation through this EGFR pathway. EGFR inhibitors are categorized into two main classes. The first class includes monoclonal antibodies, while the second class comprises small molecule inhibitors. As the name suggests, monoclonal antibodies are antibodies against receptors. They inhibit the following signal transduction by preventing ligands from binding to receptors. The main EGFR monoclonal antibody drugs are cetuximab and panitumumab. Since mab is at the end of the word, you can tell it's a monoclonal antibody, right?
Question. Please list two main EGFR monoclonal antibody drugs.
The main EGFR monoclonal antibody drugs are cetuximab and panitumumab. On the other hand, these small molecules target tyrosine kinases. Let's check right from the start. When ligands bind to their extracellular domain, they trigger receptor dimerization, which then activates receptor tyrosine kinases using ATP. Tyrosine kinase inhibitors bind to tyrosine kinases, resulting in the blocking of downstream signal transduction. Among the notable tyrosine kinase inhibitors are erlotinib, gefitinib, and afatinib.
EGF.
The suffix nib indicates a small molecule inhibitor of kinase enzymes. More specifically, tinib is used for tyrosine kinase inhibitors.
Question. Please list three main tyrosine kinase inhibitors.
EGF.
Monoclonal antibody drugs targeting EGFR are employed in colorectal cancer treatment, while tyrosine kinase inhibitors are utilized for non-small cell lung cancer. When using EGFR monoclonal antibody drugs, especially for colorectal cancer, it's crucial to check for RAS mutations.
What is RAS?
RAS is a key part of the signaling pathway. If there are mutations, it stays active even without normal signals. So, blocking signals from the receptors above doesn't stop cancer cells from growing. RAS mutations are common in cancer, especially colorectal cancer. That's why it's important to test for RAS mutations before deciding to use EGFR monoclonal antibody drugs.
Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos, hit the subscribe button.